Today, I'm gonna share with you how much I made for the entire year of 2020. So if you're curious, keep watching. Hi you guys, welcome back. Thanks so much for being here. So I know many times if you're a content creator or influencer or you're trying to become one, you're really curious about how much we actually make. So today I'm gonna open up and share with you some information that I hope will be helpful to you. If you're new here, my name is Angel. This is my second YouTube channel where I share behind the scenes of being a content creator and influencer. I am a content creator with over 1 million following across the board on YouTube, on Pinterest, on Twitter, on Facebook, Instagram, all of those platforms. I am literally the most diversified influencer, so you can find me. I will leave links to all my platforms below. I hope you do subscribe to this channel if you want to learn more about behind the scenes of being an influencer and creator. Last year was very, very interesting. A few things happened. TikTok became monetizable. Is that a word? They created a monetization revenue stream, so it's called the Creators Fund. And then on top of the other ways, and then also, what else happened last year? Anyway, I think that was the biggest change as far as monetization wise. I have always been in their creators marketplace, which is completely different. That's for brand sponsorships. But I think that's the only major change or income stream source that was added to my revenue streams last year. And I did a whole video about how to monetize TikTok and make money on that platform. I think I've actually done almost every platform, including Facebook and all of those. So if you're curious and want to know how to monetize all the other platforms that are out there, be sure to check those videos out. So today I'm gonna break down all of my categories of income and I'm gonna share with you guys like how much I made from those categories. Now, I won't share the exact amount because I just don't want people in my business like that, but I will share my percentages. So how much of my entire income from 2020 came from what source? Hopefully that still will help you get an idea of how we make our money and where a lot of it comes from. Let's just jump right in and get started, okay? So for my largest category, my biggest chunk of income as a content creator came from brand sponsorships. So 42% of my income was from brand deals and brand sponsorships. And that's where a brand pays you to work with their product and to share their product on your channel or a platform. Many times sponsorships are most creators' bread and butter. I, however, am really trying to get away from brand sponsorships and I'm not a big fan of them. I'll go more into that a little bit later and I'm actually gonna share with you guys my goals for this year and how I want my income levels to be this year. So keep watching to find out where I'm headed and where I'm trying to go. So that was my number one chunk of income. It was from brand sponsorships. My second largest source of income came from AdSense. And AdSense is when ads play on both YouTube and my blog. So I have AdSense for both accounts, my other YouTube channel, and then also I have ads on my blog. So this channel is not yet monetized as of today, but we are trying to get there and we should get there really soon. That was my second largest. My third largest income stream came from, guys, I'm looking at my tablet right here, my affiliate commissions. So I have talked about affiliates a lot on this channel. I am a huge lover of affiliate commissions and making money with affiliates, and I'll go more into why in just a few minutes, so stay with me. But that came in at 20% of my income from last year. As you can see, my three largest chunks were sponsorships, AdSense, and affiliates. So my next level of income that came in at 6% was my store sales, and that's from my two stores. I have a store shop, angelgrace.com, that I share a lot of my printables and all of that, my digital products. And then I also have Creators Academy, which is made for you guys, you know, for this channel. It's a lot of digital products that I share information with. So those sales came at 6%. And I actually didn't create Creators Academy until the end of the year. So that was very interesting. But I had my shop, Angel Grace, all year. Now, my last two income streams for being a content creator, the last two that kind of fell in place was my income from TikTok and Facebook. Now, again, that's not with brand deals. All of my brand deals was chunked into my brand sponsorships. So I did get brand deals on those platforms, but this is purely from income from that platform. So from ads or whatever they pay for you posting for your views. So yeah, they came in at the very bottom. Now, I am going to share with you my goals for this year and how I want my income level structured for this year. What I really want to do is I want my Google AdSense to be my number one income source this year. I want it to be from, of course, my lifestyle channel. And then I also want it from this channel, which I hope to get monetized really soon because we have met the 1,000 subscriber mark. So thank you guys. Yay. So now we're just working on those 4,000 minimum minutes. Thank you guys for watching. That is another goal for this year, to get this channel monetized. And then I still have my blog up and going, and I'm actually doing more blog posts and getting more traffic from my blog too, like through Pinterest and stuff. So, and I talk about that a lot in previous videos. My second income source that I want for this year to be is from Amazon. And I specifically separated that one out because I am doing more live streams. I'm a live stream creator. I have a custom deal with them. And also, Amazon affiliates is just, I want to separate it out and I want to push more on that. So I really want Amazon to be my next largest income source this year. So if you are following me on my other social media channels, you probably have seen me post more about Amazon and push more of my affiliates there and my Amazon live streams. So that's my goal for this year. And then my third income source that I want to be my largest source is my other affiliates. So everything else, I'm putting all of that in a group. So all of my other affiliate income streams, and that's a variety. One of the ones I really like is Magic Links. I'll leave a link below if you guys want to sign up. Make sure you use my link. I have used them for a long time and I really do like them. Also, I have used Like to Know It, ShareSale. There's so many other affiliate marketing companies out there. There are a lot of them. But I want that whole income stream to be my next one. And you're probably like, why? I have pushed brand sponsorships to one of my very bottoms. Because I'm going to tell you guys why I really like affiliates more than brand sponsorships. Now, and I'm a lawyer, okay? So these brand deals and the contracts is one, a nuisance and a headache. And especially when you don't really agree with the brand and you can't really, I don't want to say 100% say what you want to say, because I have gotten into it with brands where, because I'm an honest person, and the reason why people buy what I recommend is because they trust me, okay? So I'm genuine and I like my audience to trust what I'm telling them. So I don't like to just give all the good and, you know, the pros of a product. I like to tell people the pros and the cons, things I like, things I don't like, because honestly, it's really hard to find anything you're 100% happy with. There are some things that I am 100% happy with, like my hat. But, you know, like, I just like to be completely upfront with my audience. And so that way, I am putting the ball in their court whether or not they want to spend their money and buy the product. And that's worked really well for me, because that's why I make so much from affiliates and so much off of my deals, because people trust me. And with brand deals, like, it's hard because a lot of times they fight me back on things that I say. And I'm like, I'm sorry. You know, that's how I am with my audience. I like to be 100% honest. They don't like you to talk about the cons or the things you don't like. They like for you to put your focus on the positives and the things that you like. And I just disagree with them a lot. And so it's just a headache. Sorry, y'all. That's Ace, my baby. It's just a headache going back and forth with these brands about what I'm saying, and they're, you know, they want to control what you say because they're paying you. So I just, it just really gets on my nerves with that. And I've grown this far because I'm genuine and honest with my audience. And then two, they like to have a lot of creative control. And I'm like, yo, you want to use my audience. I have grown my audience. So that means I know a little bit about what I'm doing, okay? And I know how to sell a product. And I hate brands that are very controlling. They want to control this. They want to control how long. They want to control your shot. They want to control. It's just I hate brands that want creative control. And I'm running into that more and more often. So, you know, I'm really leaning less towards brand deals. Unless it's a brand that I've worked with in the past and have no issues with, and, you know, they let me say what I want to say, because I'm going to give you a great example. This Ron Brand deal I got last year was, and it's still one of my hands down best deals I've gotten. The pay structure was based on a few things. They gave me a flat rate for creating the content, and then they also pay me affiliate commissions. So that means I get a piece of money anytime someone purchases through my link. So that's incentive for me to push people to buy. And yeah, I also got ad revenue because it was for YouTube. And I actually had two deals like that last year, and they really worked well. But the one in particular, actually both of them, they never asked me not to say anything bad. I said the things that I like, the things that I don't like. And because I was honest with my audience, that's the number one selling product. I have made a killing off of that one deal just because they were not controlling. And me being honest builds, again, trust. And I try to tell brands that, and I try to use them as an example. Don't limit what I say about your product. It's not going to stop people from buying. And I use that product all the time as an example. That's the number one seller. And people buy the product, good and bad things that I say about it, you know. It's because I'm allowing consumers to make that choice once I'm upfront with them. But other brands, they just don't. It's like a headache. So I really, unless I can get brand deals like that, that are less burdensome. They don't want you to do retakes, because that's another thing. A lot of brands want you to do like retakes, and they didn't like this and didn't like that, even though I gave them everything they asked for. And you know, when they see it, they're like, well, can we have this done this way? I'm like, no, my time is valuable. I've told brands no in a heartbeat, and I think that's that lawyer in me. I'm not that sucker, you know, and a lot of influencers fall for that, brands letting them run all over them. I'm not the one. I don't let brands run all over me. But that's just all in one, a little bit of vent there. But that's the reason why I want to pull back on brand deals. It's just a headache overall, and I want to focus more on my other income sources. Back to my list. So that's my third that I want to be the biggest this year. And then following that, I want it to be for my store and product and digital sales. So again, that's from my Shop Angel Grace store and from Creators Academy. I do want to put out some more educational products. So you guys, drop me a comment below. Some things you want me to take out the time to create a workshop on, or, you know, course or ebook. It doesn't really matter. I want to focus on what you want. So whatever you want from me, drop me a comment and let me know, and we'll get the ball rolling. And then my last few categories will be sponsorships and TikTok and Facebook. I'm gonna let them just kind of fall where they may. Now, the interesting thing is, this will be a full year of receiving funds from the TikTok Creator Fund. But if it runs anything like the end of last year, I mean, I don't think it'll be like money to like live off of. You know, unless something changes, who knows? And I can't really say how much I'm getting on there because they have this confidentiality agreement. But I can tell you that it's not nothing compared to what I make on YouTube. And then Facebook. Well, you know, it's so amazing because I recently was reached out to from Facebook, and they have created me a Facebook account manager. Well, someone from Facebook who works with me directly. I have that direct contact, and they want to help me to grow and help me to actually get bigger, which I'm already pretty big on Facebook. I have about, it's like over 750,000, so I'm going towards that million mark. So it's pretty cool to have that direct connect with someone at Facebook, and they're giving me some ins and some intel knowledge, which is pretty cool too, you guys. So if y'all keep hanging with me, I will be helping y'all out. And actually, as a matter of fact, the next video that I'm gonna shoot is gonna be about Facebook and Facebook pages. So make sure to stay tuned for that or go check it out. So I don't know where my Facebook income is gonna go this year. I don't know, as far as just ads, not talking about brand sponsorships, but I don't know, I guess we'll see. I'm testing some things out, so we shall see. That covers my hierarchy of levels of my income just from being a content creator and influencer. And I do have other sources of income, and I've shared those in the past, but this is directly just from me being an influencer. So I hope that gives you guys an idea of, you know, where I'm at and how I make a living from doing this. And if you want to know any more information, drop me a comment below and let me know. Talk to me. I also have an Instagram page you guys can check out. It's called Angel's Creators Corner. Again, it's for creators, it's for influencers, it's for anybody who wants to use social media for business and to grow and to become a brand. So make sure to follow along. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next video.